are so excited to be on campus today at Southern Oregon University in Ashland. We're right in front of the Science Building. Science was one of my best topics in school.
I did not know that.
Because it's not true. Do you hear what's happening, though?
Yes. What is that noise?
Well, always, there's always something happening on campus. There's a building right over there, Dave, and they're actually getting ready to make it solar ready. So they're doing all sorts of work over there, and that's what we're hearing in the background.
So they're constantly working. SOU is constantly upgrading their sustainability. We're talking about they have the largest solar array in Ashland. They also have at least 16 charging stations for EVs.
Plus, 12% of campus fleet vehicles are hybrids or EVs, and 80% of SOU maintenance equipment is electric.
They're taking sustainability to the next level. They've reduced traditional lawn, replacing it with drought-tolerant ground cover, and this campus was the first bee campus in the U.S. You will see pollinator gardens all over the place. Speaking of, I'm going to go check one out. Look at this beautiful pollinator garden here, right in front of the Stevenson Union. So many of these on campus, too.
There's plenty of them all over, which is really beautiful for our students and any guests that we have on campus, too.
I'm here with Sierra Garrett. She's not only a student, but she's also with the sustainability department. Very curious, what drew you to study sustainability?
Now, I'd always had an interest in things that were environmental, but I never felt like that was something that I could do. You know, I didn't grow up like rock climbing or anything like that. And so I was like, I don't know if I can join it. But then I looked at the sustainability major. I saw that it encompassed all of these like social sides and political sides and economic sides. And I was like, that's something I'm really interested in. I joined that major and it's been a dream ever since. It's been absolutely turned into my main focus. Everywhere I go, I'm like, sustainability, sustainability.
Well, I was going to ask, how has your experience here at SOU, how has that changed the way you think about sustainability?
Well, first, yeah, incorporating, it's not just environmental, it's social, it's economic, it's the way that we build communities and everything. And my time spent at like the SOU farm, for example, has really sparked my interest in sustainable food systems. Just having those experiences, I probably wouldn't have discovered my love for agriculture and in that way specifically. But also there's really unique opportunities that come with being a part of the like sustainability major or just involved in sustainability on campus in general. So I've attended different conferences, I've spoken at a conference, I've had international travel where I'm examining sustainability through different lenses. So I would not have had access to all of that if I was not a student here, meeting the professors, meeting all of the professional people on campus and making those connections.
Go SOU.
Right? Yeah.
I love that. How can students here on campus get involved in sustainability then?
So I'd say the most basic way for students to get involved, just get like a little teaser, is to take a class. So many of our departments, even if they're not sustainability focused or like environmental science, for example, there's tons of classes that have to do with sustainability in plenty of departments. There's business classes, there's art classes, there's sociology and anthropology classes. So whatever your major is, likely there's a chance, or you know, a good chance that sustainability is going to be a part of that. Then we also have ASSOU, which is our Associated Students of SOU. We have our Environmental Affairs Committee. So that's the committee that takes care of Green Fund projects and making sure that student voices are heard around campus around issues of sustainability. And there's plenty of jobs around campus. Right. There's the Institute for Applied Sustainability, the Office of Sustainability. There's sustainable jobs all over campus, like in landscaping, for example. So there's plenty of opportunities for students, whether they want to start with something small, just be a part of a conversation, or dedicate themselves to it through a major, through a job, or anything like that. We really try to make it accessible for people because sustainability is not truly sustainable without accessibility.
Very cool. And we're going to talk about the Green Fund Project a little bit later, but there's so many different pockets of sustainability here. And which brings me to my co-host, Dave. Let's go see what he's up to.
Thanks, Trish. I'm here at SOU on the campus talking to the Director of Sustainability for SOU, Bex Walker. Bex, can you tell us, what does sustainability really mean to you?
Thanks, Dave. Sustainability to me means how we can contribute to a healthier environment, social justice, as well as a stronger economy. It's not about trade-offs between them. It's about how we can build better, how we can make the future more beautiful, and think about our actions as individuals, think about our actions as organizations, and think about our actions as businesses, because we all have an impact on the future.
Well, and how are you helping that to happen right here on the campus?
So we think about the actions we can take as an organization at SOU. As a campus, I think of us as a small city, a small town. We need to use materials and we produce waste. We need to use energy, we need to operate our buildings. So we need to think about how we use the waste, the energy, and what we can do to be more sustainable in the way we do that. We also think about our landscape, providing space for pollination, water conservation, biodiversity as well. So everything we do is about operating sustainably. We're also a place of learning. So we can build it into our academic programs, from having a sustainability major through to building it into all programs. And we can pilot innovative technology or capstones and internships on campus to learn from and be more sustainable in the future.
Well, and I know you do that in a lot of different interesting ways. So if you don't mind, let's walk around and you can kind of explain.
That sounds good.
Looks like we're on a farm.
It does look like we're on a farm. SOU takes sustainability to a completely different level. This campus acts as a microcosm and really a bed for sustainable life for larger communities. Really cool. We are back at the farm with Sierra. I know these projects take money, right? So talk to me about the Green Fund.
Yeah, so the Student Green Fund is run through our Student Green Tag fee. So essentially students pay a very small fee each term that they're at school. That fee gets put into a very, very large pot of money called the Student Green Fund. Mm. And essentially students can select some of that money for any sort of sustainability project that they want to start on campus, whether it has to do with food waste or water conservation or anything. So a student can write an application, fill out an application, work with our office to make sure that it's a good project. It's going to actually get some work done. And then we see those projects all around campus. So some of those examples are water bottle refill stations that were put all around campus. You see them in pretty much every building. In 2021, we had reusable towel stations put in so that we could make things more sustainable in all of our buildings across campus. The farm. The farm started out as a Green Fund project in 2017, and it was seriously just a couple rows of plants, of mm-hmm. vegetables. And since then, it has transformed into nearly 10 acres. We produce fruit, vegetables, we have bees, we have grapes for wine production, flowers, all sorts of different things. And the great thing about this space is that we're not just doing it for our campus. So we actually provide food for all of the schools in the Ashland School District. We have a community-supported agriculture program. We'll sell at farmers markets. And it's also not just about what we're producing. It's about the community that we're building here, too. So we'll hold classes, ceremonies, events, celebrations like Earth Day, things that really bring people together. And that's something that's really impacted me, too. Yeah. So this space is really important to me. It's important to all sorts of students. And many times you're biting into something that was actually grown at the farm.
Just a few miles away. You had me at wine production, but this is really bringing the community at large together, not just the students.
Absolutely. Everybody is welcome on this farm. We can show you what we're doing. You can come volunteer with us, take classes. I mean, this space is absolutely open for everybody in any sort of way that people want to interact with it.
Go SOU. Thanks, Sierra.
Yeah, of course.
So I'm back here with Bex, and I have a question about energy management and resilience. What's SOU doing?
SOU has the goal to generate 100% of our daytime electricity on campus through renewable energy and be the first public university to do this, which is really exciting. We're a small public university, and to have this generated on campus is quite an achievement. We already have 10 solar arrays on 8 buildings. 3 of these solar arrays are on net zero buildings, which means that those buildings use less electricity that is generated by the solar. So we're able to provide electricity to other parts of campus. We've recently installed the largest solar array for SOU, and it is actually the largest solar array for SOU for the city of Ashland. So it's 210 kilowatts, and combined with the 60 kilowatts, we have a huge solar array on the building behind us, Lithium Motors Pavilion. We then have a couple more coming in on the dining hall behind us, which is in front of us, which is exciting because we're combining that with battery storage so that in the event of an emergency, we can do basic food provisions for first responders, SOU community, and potentially the wider community, which is part of an emergency management agreement that we have with the City of Ashland and the Ashland School District to provide an emergency management center and to also do what else we can in the event of an emergency. We also have funding for our first parking lot solar array, which is really exciting. It will provide shading for the cars in this heat that we're experiencing, as well as generate 300, be the capacity of 330 kilowatts for a solar array, which will be then our largest solar array on campus. So we're progressively building up to our goal of 100% of our daytime electricity generated by solar. As well as all this solar generation, we need to think about how we manage our energy and how we can use it more efficiently. So we regularly maintain the buildings in terms of the heating and cooling. We do upgrades to our boilers and chillers on campus, as well as the lighting on campus. And we have to think about how we can be more efficient in the way we use it as well. What's interesting is we have the building behind us is actually LEED Gold. And one of the reasons it was certified with the LEED Gold is because it uses 22% less electricity than it would generally use for a building of that size and of that use. And that's because of the way it's designed and the way it's used in terms of the efficiency around energy. In 2022, we were very lucky to receive a significant donation from Lithia and Driveway. And part of that was to establish an Institute for Applied Sustainability. Each year, we invite faculty to apply in terms of a program related, a research project related to sustainability that they can do in partnership with the Institute for Applied Sustainability. We're also looking at expanding our internships and building on the community engagement side at the Institute. And as part of this, what's exciting is that we bring all parts of sustainability on campus together. What more can we do the way we operate the campus to build it into academic programs?
There is something that we've been noticing everywhere we go. There are these three trash cans, color-coded trash cans. What's that all about?
So the three color-coded trash cans, the red, the black, and the blue. So it's really important that when you're thinking about putting in a waste management system, you identify with what goes where. So as well as signage, colors is a good way of identifying it. So all over campus, this is standardized, and the black means it is landfill. So it's just going to go into trash. It's not going to be able to be recycled. The red is for glass, and we're able to recycle that, as well as pull out the glass that we can get cash back through the Oricon bottle deposit return. And then the blue is for the recycling. So if you do have recycling, it goes in the blue, and it's clearly labeled what can go in there. Often we see a lot, and this is great having the recycling center, we see a lot of non-recyclable materials come through the recycling center because people are hopeful that it can be recycled. But I always say, if in doubt, leave it out.
We ask everybody that comes on the show this question. What kind of car do you drive?
So I drive a Ford Transit van that I've built out for adventures at the moment, but I am looking to complement that with a smaller vehicle currently.
Well, and we also ask this, if price were no object and you could buy any EV, what would you buy?
I think, okay, what's important to me, and this is where sustainability comes in, spending power is important. So we should think about the company we're buying from as well as the vehicle itself. I've been impressed for an automobile business in terms of the strides that Toyota has done in terms of pushing boundaries and research, but also its actions it takes around social justice and environmental sustainability in the way it operates. Based on that, and I'm thinking the car that I'd like, I'd probably go for a Toyota RAV4.
Well, good heavens. Pretty cool, huh? Thank you so much, Bex, for your time today. It's been a great pleasure.
Thank you.
You bet.
In front of the Stevenson Union, this is a solar power dock.
Yes.
We've decided to charge all of our equipment for a few minutes. This was actually a student green fund. Project, right?
Yeah, so somebody was really passionate about still sitting outdoors, but being able to like charge the tech that's really necessary for day-to-day use and doing our homework and stuff like that. So we have this area. It's a big picnic bench that has solar panels on the top. You can come in, plug in, and use this space however you need to use it.
I love it. So Sierra, this is a podcast called Green Cars,
yes,
the podcast. We ask all of our guests on Green Cars, the podcast, what car do you currently drive?
Yes. So I currently drive, I'm a little sad to say it, I drive a 1998 4Runner. I love the car, but, you know, I know it's not, maybe not the most environmentally friendly. It's just what was available at the time.
No shame, no shame. But if price was not an issue, what would you get? What EV would you get?
Yeah, I'd probably get, some type of Kia maybe, because I've driven them before. They're really nice and very comfortable. And then I also like that, you know, they're pretty big. You can, you know, get some friends in there. You can go camping. You can get all your gardening supplies, everything in there. And I think that's really, really fitting for my lifestyle right now.
Love it. Well, you have been so much fun to chat with, and you're quite the smarty pants.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, we've had a lot of fun with Sierra today and really teaching me about all the things on campus that are very sustainable.
There's
I'm going to share that with the world.
Yeah,
it's
and come
exciting.
Back for more. There's so much more.
Will do. Thanks, Sierra.
Thanks.
What a day. What a fun day. I know we didn't talk a lot about electric vehicles, but I learned so much when it comes to sustainability here on the SOU campus.
And see, that's the beauty. You never know what we're going to do here on Green Cars, the podcast. We're here at SOU today. Where are we going to be next time? Think about that in your mind if you can.
Yeah. So you always have to be watching us. As always, stay informed, stay charged. We'll see you next time.
Go up. What was that thing?
Follow us at GreenCars HQ. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Email us the podcast at greencars.com.